Hi, welcome back to another season of Eagle TV.
Oh boy, we're back.
And this season we have new boot cast members and new segments.
As well as some returning segments, but we are putting some twists on old ones.
Well, I hope you enjoy the show.
Do you know where bad light goes to?
Where?
Prism.
Oh!
Where does bad light go to?
Down below.
Prism. Where does bad light go to?
I don't know.
Prism.
Hi, welcome back to another season of Eagle TV. If you're new here, hi, hello, my name is Summer, and this is my segment, Summer States. Last year, I ended this season off with Louisiana, so I'm going to start off this season with Maine. Did you know that Portland, Oregon is actually named after Portland, Maine? I didn't even know there was a Portland, Maine. Also, did you know that Maine is the only state which borders only one of the U.S. state, which is New Hampshire? On the other side of it is the Canadian province of New Brunswick and Quebec. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode and stick around for next week.
Hi, I'm Griffin Harrell, and welcome to Did You Know? Did you know that following the release of the Windows Phone, Microsoft held a funeral for Apple's iPhone? I'm Griffin Harrell, and now you know.
Welcome to Give Me Five. My name is Macy. This is my segment, Give Me Five, where I tell you the top five best or worst things for the week. Today's topic is ice cream. Based on Newsweek, they placed mint chocolate chip at number, five. Personally, I would place it lower than number five because, in my opinion, it is not at all that great. And then at number four, we have butter pecan. I haven't tried that, so maybe I should try it. And then at number three, we have, which is my favorite flavor, which is strawberry. In my opinion, it is at the top. Then almost at the top, at number two, is vanilla. It's okay. And then finally, at the very top, we have chocolate. I don't like chocolate, but a lot of people do. I think it should be a little lower, but that's okay. That is all for today's Give Me Five. Thank you for watching, and make sure to come back for next time's Give Me Five.
Welcome to Let's Review Season 3. Boy, that doesn't sound as good as the Season 2, now does it? Now, this year's been different because obviously I'm back. I know, woohoo, everyone's happy. But now we have Ethan here. Say hi, Ethan.
Hi, Ethan.
So now it's an actual Let's Review instead of me talking to you all the time. So what's our first topic today?
Today we will be talking about The Mandalorian, you know, the Star Wars show.
Yeah, with the guy in it looks like a clone trooper, but not. It looks like Jango Fett and Boba Fett. So, the story of Mandalorian, I thought it was a very good story. I mean, you know, post-Empire, pre-First Order, that's a pretty good concept. It's a very blank space in the universe. What do you think?
I believe they did pretty good with touching about the old Mandalorian codes, all the different Mandalorian stuff, like they brought the Darksaber in, they brought the classic style of the armor, the jetpack with the rocket on the back.
And then they brought Boba Fett back, and everyone loves Boba Fett. I thought, yeah, the inclusion of the Darksaber was very good. I liked Moff Gideon. I felt like he was a lot more fleshed out in Season 2 rather than just being, oh, I'm smart. Oh, look at me. Oh, I'm so good.
He was very much that main villain type of character.
And then he died, I think. I don't remember entirely, but I think he's dead. And then there's the whole point of Grogu. Grogu, really. Oh, boy. Grogu. Ah, Grogu and Luke. I, no. Sorry. I wanted a force-free show, thank you. But I don't think we're going to get it.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I even have my own theory that the Mandalorian might actually be force-sensitive. That's why he has the Darksaber now.
Oh, yeah.
Because he will be the first force-sensitive Mandalorian since Tar Vizsla, who originally had the Darksaber. But on the topic of news, there's actually news that the Book of Boba Fett, which is the new kind of series, because we saw Boba Fett obviously returning in Season 2, that's actually started filming, and they're supposed to be coming out with it fall or winter of this year, and Mandalorian Season 3 started filming. That's pretty interesting. Coming out next year, probably.
Wow.
So, what would you give the show on a scale of 1 to 10? That's kind of what we do here.
I believe I'd give the Mandalorian a 7.5 out of 10.
I'd give it a 8.5, maybe a 9. So that gives the Mandalorian about a 8.5, maybe 9 8. Total scale 10.
I don't think a 9, just an 8 out of 10 overall.
Well, yeah, maybe. But on that note, that's been Let's Review. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.
Can you name one of the southern states that seceded to form the Confederacy?
Texas?
That is correct. You are smarter than a fifth grader. Good job. Can you name one of the southern states that seceded from the Union to start the Civil War?
No.
All right. I guess you're not smarter than a fifth grader then. Do you have any comment on that?
No.
Understandable.
Hi, I'm Jordan.
And I'm Lily, and welcome to Famous Facts. In this segment, we will share with you some facts about famous people or famous events that you probably didn't know about. To start things off is actress Dove Cameron. Many people don't know that her real name isn't Dove. She changed her name from Chloe Hosterman to Dove Cameron after her father passed away.
Really? That's so sad.
I know, right? But here's another fact. Actress Zendaya's birthday is coming up on September 1st. Do you have any facts?
Actually, I do. You may know her as Marilyn Monroe, but her actual name is Norma Jean.
Wow, many people don't go by their real name.
I know, right? Actually, I have another one I know of.
Really?
Yeah, it's the singer Bruno Mars. His real name is actually Peter Hernandez.
I have one more to mention. September 6, 1620, the Mayflower departed from England, headed toward America with 102 passengers and a small crew.
That's crazy. I actually have a few birthdays to mention as well. The first one goes out to Summer Jones, that you may know her from Summer States. Her birthday is August 28th. Secondly is Austin Hill from Let's Review. His birthday is September 24th. And lastly, a special birthday to Mr. Nevins, our secondary teacher, on the 9th of September.
That's it for Famous Facts. Can't wait to see you next week. Bye!
Welcome to Tech Talk. I'm Cole, and today we'll be talking about the pros and cons of PlayStation versus Xbox. First off, Xbox has better memory, storage, and graphics. PlayStation has many exclusives such as God of War, Horizon Zero Dawn, and Spider-Man. Xbox has the Halo series and Forza Horizon. PlayStation exclusives have won 4 Game of the Year awards, while Xbox games have only won 1. In conclusion, Xbox has better specs and is built like a PC, but PlayStation has better games and better cinematics. In my opinion, PlayStation is better because there's no point in having good graphics if there's no good games to use it with. This has been Tech Talk, and I'll see you techies next week.
Hello, my name is Claire, and welcome to Claire's Clues, where each week I will be giving you 2 clues that hint to an answer that will be given to you in next week's segment. The first clue is that it is a living thing that has wings. The second clue is that it will attack you if you disturb them, so always be careful. Thank you for joining me today with Claire's Clues, and don't forget to tune in next week for the answer.
Well, that was a great show. What do you think?
I really like the show.
Well, that does it for week 1. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.